children. So today we'll start the new chapter in class 8 chemistry, that is atomic structure. So you all know about matter. I have already discussed many times what is matter. Once again I want to tell you, matter is that which occupies space and has mass. And all matter is made up of very small particles, which is called atoms. So atom is the smallest particle of any matter. And Maharshi Kennard, he was an Indian philosopher, he described matter in the matter. The atom is the smallest particle in the form of Parmanu or Anu. So he called the atom as Parmanu or Anu. He also told that this Parmanu and Anu is still made up of small particles. They are called subatomic particles. They are called protons, electrons and neutrons. Protons which are positively charged, electrons which are negatively charged and neutrons which have no charge. No charge means it is neither positive nor negative. So these are the subdivisible particles, as also described by Democritus in his theory, that atom is divided into protons, electrons and neutrons. Now in this chapter we will study the different atomic structure, atomic models given by different scientists. That is the Thomson's atomic model, Rutherford atomic model, Bohr's atomic model and conclusion of all the three, that is the modern atomic structure. So before studying the different models given by the different scientists, I will tell you about the Dalton's atomic theory. John Dalton, he was a scientist and he described few features of the atoms in his theory. He described that all matter is made up of very small particles which are called atom, as described by Maharshi Kennard also, as well as by Democritus. So all matter is made up of very small particle called atom, and John Dalton also described that atom is indivisible particle which can neither be created nor destroyed. And atoms, all the atoms of an element, they are identical in mass and properties. This was also the statement given by John Dalton in his theory. And the fourth one is that atoms combine together to form molecules and compounds. Like if we combine two hydrogen atoms, then two hydrogen atoms combine together to form hydrogen molecule, H2 molecule. In the same way, two chlorine atoms, if they are combined together, they form chlorine atoms, that is Cl2 molecule. In the same way, when hydrogen, two atoms of hydrogen combines with one atom of oxygen, it forms water molecule. So this is a water, is a compound, but here hydrogen molecule, chlorine, and these are the molecules. So now we'll study about, so these are the four points mostly which are given by the John Dalton in his theory, that all matter is made up of very small particles called atom. Atom is indivisible particle. It was also described by John Dalton, and he also said that all the atoms of an element are identical in mass and properties, and atoms combine together to form molecules and compounds. Now let's discuss about the models given by different scientists. So first we'll describe the Thomson's atomic model. Thomson's atomic model was described by J.J. Thomson. So J.J. Thomson was a scientist who gave the Thomson's atomic model. According to his model, what happens? He described that all atoms, they are the protons which are outside. Means all atom is made up of protons, and inside the proton the electrons are embedded. This theory was given by J.J. Thomson in his Thomson's atomic model. So these are the protons which are positively charged. or in a positively charged sphere the electrons are embedded. This theory was given by J.J. Thomson in his Thomson's atomic model. But Thomson did not describe the atomic structure properly, so his model failed. Means he only described that in a sphere the protons are present and inside electrons are present. So this was not the proper theory given by Thomson. That's why his model failed, and he also compared this model with a watermelon. Like in the watermelon, the fleshy part he described as protons, and the inside part, that is the seed part, which is black, which are present scattered inside the watermelon, he described it as electrons. He also described his model with the plum pudding model. Just like the watermelon model, watermelon theory he gave. So here also, whatever the edible part, he described it as the protons, and whatever the dry fruits which are embedded inside the pudding, they he described as electrons. So he compared his model with the watermelon as well as with the pudding. But anyway, his model failed because it does not describe the theories which was given by the Rutherford. Now, the second model that we will study, that is about the Rutherford model. Ernest Rutherford, he was also a scientist. He described the atomic structure in his model, Rutherford atomic model. His experiment was also described as scattering experiment, because he took a gold foil and did a scattering experiment. He bombarded the gold foil, and what did he see? That he see by bombarding the alpha rays, what did he found? That most of the rays passed through the gold foil. Some of the rays got deflected from their path, and few of the rays got rebound. So when he did his scattering experiment, this is a scattering experiment done by the Rutherford, and after doing this experiment, what did he observe? So he gave the observation, and in his theory he gave the observation that most of the atom, the space is empty. Because of the empty space only, most of the rays pass through the gold foil. And second most important thing, he found that most of the protons, they are present in the nucleus. So, atom as a whole, whatever the mass which is concentrated in the nucleus, that was the theory given by the Rutherford. He also described that most of the center part are, which he called as nucleus, in which the protons and neutrons are present. Protons which are positively charged and neutrons which have no charge, and both of them together he formed and he called as nucleons. But one drawback in his model was that he did not describe the stability of the atom. Stability of the atom means when the electrons revolve, what happens due to high energy state, the atom fall, or the proton, the electron which is present outside, they fall in the nucleus. As a result, the atom as a whole is not, we can say they are not stable. And because of that instability, his model also was not proved properly, and his model also failed. But most of the things he described that was good for in his theory, and he described also that most of the empty space in the atom, he called it as nucleus, and most of the atom has mass which is concentrated in the nucleus only, in which the protons and neutrons are present, but we did not describe the stability of the atom. So after his theory, another scientist gave the theory that is called Bohr's atomic model. In his Bohr's atomic model, some few points are taken from the Rutherford model, but few things he described more apart from the Rutherford model. And the thing was that Bohr was a scientist, his full name was Niels Bohr, and he described Bohr's atomic model. And he said that in the center the nucleus is present, and outside the nucleus the shells or different orbits are present. This was also given by Rutherford. So inside the nucleus is present, and these are the shells or the orbits which are present outside, and these shells were given the name shell 1, shell 2 or shell 3 and so on. Or he also named it as K, L, M, N and so on. Like shell 1 was given the name K, he started from the letter K. Shell 2 he gave it as L. Shell 3 he gave termed it as M. And inside the center part he called this nucleus, in which the protons and neutrons were present. Protons which are positively charged and neutrons which have no charge. So this most of the means mass of the atom is concentrated in the nucleus. This theory was also given by Rutherford, as well as it is also given by Bohr, and this theory was also proved far better than the Thomson's model. And this theory, what theory he gave, that the mass of the atom is concentrated in the nucleus because the protons are there as well as the neutrons are there, and the mass of the proton is equal to the mass of the electron also, or we can say the number of proton an atom has, that much electron that atom will also have. This mass is concentrated inside the nucleus, and outside the different orbits are there in which the electrons revolve. So these are the theories given by Niels Bohr in his Niels Bohr's atomic model, that electrons revolve around the nucleus. And he gave the different shells or orbits which he termed as, already told you, K, L, M, N and so on. And he also described two states in the atom, that is the excited state and the ground state. He also described how the electrons are distributed in different shells, distribution of electrons. So distribution of electrons was also described by the Bohr's model. And according to Bohr, the atom is stable, as Rutherford stated that, or he did not able to explain the stability of the atom, but the stability of the atom was described by the Bohr, means he described the stability of atom. That's why his theory was proved far better than the Thomson model, Rutherford model and any other model. So he mainly explained about the stability of the atom. And in his stability, what it is described, that while the electrons revolve around the nucleus, it does not lose energy. This theory was given by Bohr, and that's why the electrons, they do not fall in the nucleus, and as a result the atom as a whole is stable. And in his theory he gave the distribution of electrons by the formula 2n square, According to 2n squared, how much electrons are distributed in different shells? So let's take the first shell like in the K shell. According to 2n squared, n is the number of shells. So we'll find out 2 into 1 square means 2 into 1 square means 1. So the first shell will occupy 2 electrons. And second shell, like in the K shell, according to 2n square, we'll find out the number of electrons. 2 into 2 square means 2 into 2 to the 4, to 2 4s are 8. So the second shell occupies 8 electrons. Third shell, if we take M shell, so here also according to the formula 2n square, 2 into 3 square. 2 into 3 square means 2 into 3 is 9, to 2 9s are 18. Means total 18 electrons will be occupied in the third shell. And in the same way, fourth shell, according to 2n square only, we can calculate the different shells in the different orbits. Like in the first shell, this is the nucleus. In the first shell, maximum 2 electrons can occupy. In the second shell, maximum 8 electrons can occupy. And in the third shell, 18 electrons. So in this way, the distribution of electrons was described by the Bohr in his Bohr's atomic model. And tomorrow we will discuss about the model theory of the atomic structure. Thank you.